What's going on, guys? Balkan Architect here, and in today's video we're going to be covering a quick little topic, but it's an important topic, and that is arrowheads inside of Revit. So when it comes to working in Revit, you're going to be using arrowheads both for, well, as arrowheads, but also as ticks inside of dimensions. So those are kind of the same thing as arrowheads in Revit. They work on the same principles. So I'm just going to be showing you how to customize this, how to set things up in order to have kind of maximum customization inside of Revit. And I'm also going to be showing you just some limitations that Revit has, unfortunately, when it comes to arrowheads. Now, if you want to learn more kind of these more, I guess, advanced features inside of Revit, I have a whole course on that topic. It's called Intermediate to Advanced Level course. It's available on my website, balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to link it up just below this video in the description, and then also up in the cards above. There you can find that course. You can find all of my other courses, ranging from beginner, intermediate, all the way to advanced level topics. Also there you can find my customized Revit templates. You can find some really high quality Revit families, and we also have a plugin, so make sure to check that out. Also, before we jump into Revit, I would just like to ask you quickly to like this video. It helps me out a lot, and also make sure to subscribe. Not only does it help you not miss any of my future videos, but more importantly, it makes the alpaca happy. And let's do that, guys. Let's make the alpaca happy. Okay, now without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit, and here we go. So the project file that I'm going to be using for this is this simple one family house. I actually have a whole course on my website where I show you step by step how to build this house. So if you're interested, you can check that out there. Now, something that is interesting about this house, and it has to do with our arrowheads, is if you zoom in, you will see that the dimensions, instead of having that regular tick that you see most often in Revit, they actually have a dot. And I like using this dot whenever kind of regulations approve. I tend to use the dot because I think it looks a lot more elegant, a lot sleeker, and I'm just going to be showing you how that works. So before we get into that, let's first create some arrowheads. Well, actually, let's just create one. So what I'm going to do is go here to the Annotate tab, and there we have the text tool. It's here on the text panel. So if you click here on the text tool, you can use the shortcut TX. Here, you want to first make sure that you have an arrowhead, or that you have a leader, and then on top of that leader, you're going to have an arrowhead. Now, you set that up here. See, we have this little leader panel on the Modify tab, and then you have four options. The first one is no leader, then we have just a regular kind of straight leader, then we have a two-segment leader, and then also we have this curved leader. I like the two-segment one, so I'm just going to click on that, and what that does is now when you want to place some text, first you click where the leader or the arrowhead is pointing, then you kind of pull out a little bit, you click to add the elbow, and then you stretch it out, and then the final third click is going to be where you place your text. And then we can say this is important. And then you can just click to kind of finalize that command. And there we go. Now we have our text, and there we have our leader. So if I hit the escape key a few times, let's now go into some of the options and settings when it comes to this arrowhead. So when we select the text, you will see that the text and the arrowhead are one thing. So they are not separate. They can be adjusted separately. You can move this around. You can move the text around. You can even move this point kind of where that text is. But you cannot move or kind of separate those as two entities. They come together. Okay, now let's go here to the properties panel, because in the properties panel is where we have some of our important settings. So here what you will see is we have the arc leaders. So if I check this on, it's just going to give me that kind of arc. I don't want that, so I'm just going to uncheck that. And then here we have some attachments, left, right, horizontal, vertical. It's basically here. It's kind of referring to all of this, so all of these attachments, so where that leader is kind of in reference to the text. Obviously, I don't want to change any of this, so I'm just going to leave that alone. Now, to get further arrowhead settings, you have to go here into Edit Type menu for that text style or that text family. And then here you will see that we have the leader border offset and we have the leader arrowhead. Now the arrowhead is important, but let's just cover this as well. So this is basically how far the offset is from the text. So by default it's set at 2 millimeters. If I set that to 0 and then hit apply, you will see it basically the line will go all the way next to that T. If I add, I don't know, like 3 millimeters and then hit apply, as you can see, it's just going to come kind of further away. So that's basically what that is setting. Now, finally, let's come to the arrowhead, which is the topic of the video, and it can be set up here. So here we have the leader arrowhead, and the arrowhead is currently the 30 degree one. Now, if you open this up, you'll see that you have many families loaded in. You can obviously go with none, and then it will be just empty, and you can go with that. This can work as well if you want. Then you have some arrows, so you have the 30 degree one, kind of the basic one, and then we have some filled ones at the different angles, so these are nice as well. Then we have the open one at 90 degrees, this one, I don't like that one, okay. And now here we have the interesting ones. First one is the diagonal 3 millimeter. Now this isn't actually an arrowhead, this is actually the tick mark. So if I click this and hit apply, as you can see, this is just a diagonal tick. It's what's usually used for dimensions. So we'll cover that later, but going further, we have this filled box, 2 millimeter, we have the filled box, filled dot, 1.5 millimeter. This is something that I've customized. I'll show you that later. And we have kind of, we have again another dot, a bigger dot. And then here we have the filled elevation target. So you know that target that's used for elevation, that elevation symbol. If you set it to that, there we go, hit apply, it's going to just add that symbol as an arrowhead. So you can use that, for example. Moving forward, we have this triangle, so you can have a triangle for some reason. We have the heavy end, which just gives you kind of a heavy end lined segment. So just the kind of the end of that line is just thicker line. Then we have again a 15 degree MEP arrow, and then we have an open dot, which is basically this. So this might be different. I actually customized this for this particular project, so it might be different, but basically that's what you get out of the box. So let's select what we want. I'm just going to go with my filled dot 1.5 millimeter because that's my favorite one. So let's hit apply. There we go. So now it looks like this. So that's basically how you customize or how you set up or choose which arrowhead you want to apply to your leader. Now, I'm also going to be showing you how to apply arrowheads here for the dimensions, and then we're going to go into arrowhead customization. So for dimensions, if I select this dimension, just like text, dimensions are families, they're system families, and you can edit the arrowhead here by going into edit type, and then here, if I go here to the tick mark, it's basically, so let's see, tick mark, here we go, it's basically an arrowhead. So if I expand the menu, you'll see we have the same options. So if I go with 20 degree filled, it's basically just going to give me that arrowhead. So that's what this tick mark is. As I said, arrowheads and tick marks are pretty much the same thing inside of Revit. They're the same families apply. And then you can go through those and you can use whatever you want. Something most common is the diagonal 3 millimeters. So if I apply that, this is what we're going to get. Now for the diagonal tick, the only difference is the fact that here for dimensions, you actually have these two additional parameters where we can set up the, or not two, here, it's one parameter actually, the tick mark line weight. So actually I can set this to be thicker. So if I go to, I don't know, like 10 and then hit apply, this will become way thicker, and then if I go to 1, it's going to be the same thickness as the rest of the dimension lines, because the line weight is set to 1 for the main dimensions. Now I'm just going to set this to 4. I like it at 4. I think it looks good. So let's click OK and exit that menu. Okay, so we've now explored how can we apply arrowheads, but where do we actually customize the arrowheads? And here is where the kind of limitations lie. So with Revit, if you go here to the Manage tab, if you go to additional settings, here we have this arrowheads menu. So if I open that up, it's going to look like this. And as you can see, all of these arrowheads are separate families. Now the thing is, we can't really create new types of arrowheads. Well, we can create new types, but we cannot really customize them. It's not like we can have a family and then we can kind of draw our own arrowhead. Revit does not allow that. And if you know someone at Autodesk, tell them, please make this, because it would be really nice. But here you're kind of limited to all of these families. So you have these arrows, then you have the diagonal one, then you have filled box, or you have boxes and dots, you have that target, triangle, heavy end, and that's it. Or again, this is another dot. So you're kind of limited to those, but you can customize them. So remember this diagonal tick that we've placed here. Well, if I select it here, I can just rename that and I can say, okay, I want this to be a 2 millimeter diagonal, click OK. And then I can go here to tick size and I can change it from 3 to 2 millimeters and then hit OK. And as you can see, it's going to become smaller here. So that's one way of making adjustments. Another way is, let's open this up, go to arrowheads, and then let's see. For example, if you have this filled box, this is a 2 millimeter filled box. If I duplicate that, I can call this one my new box, click OK. And then here I can choose, do you want to use that box? I can use a dot if I want, but I've already named this one box, so I'm just going to keep the box. I can choose, is this filled? And then I can choose which is the tick size or the size of that box. So I can go with 3 millimeters and then I can make it not filled or so fill tick. This is when you uncheck it, it's not filled anymore. So now when I click OK, I can select this text again. I can go into edit type. And then here, if I open up my leader arrowheads, I'm going to have my new box. And if I select that and click apply, as you can see, it's a 4 millimeter open box. So you can customize things like that. You do have that ability. The only annoying thing is that this line will go all the way to the center. So even though it's an open box, the line isn't going to stop at the box. It's going to go all the way to the center. So moving forward for customization, I think you're getting the point. So one more thing that I wanted to show you is, let's duplicate this one and create a new arrowhead this time. Or let's call it new arrow. Arrowhead. Okay, click OK. And now here, one of the options that we don't really have listed kind of as the default ones, but you do have the ability to customize it, is the loop. So if I select the loop, I can just click here, I can select the size, 3 millimeters, perfectly fine. And if I click OK here, if I select this text, go into edit type, go to my leader arrowhead, and if I go to my new type, let's see, where is that? Okay, new arrowhead, click apply. Okay, so this is that loop. It looks like this. It's kind of like a half ellipse, I guess. And it's just another option that you have. It's available. So if you want to use that, you do have the ability to use that. And there we go. So that's basically how you can customize these arrowheads. Of course, you can let's go here to our new arrowhead instead of the loop. I like the heavy end tick mark. So if I just use this one, this is 3 millimeters at 7 thickness. If I click OK, this is what that looks like. And then you can customize the size of it by changing the length and the thickness. So for example, if we go here and if we make it thicker but smaller, it's just going to look like a smaller kind of pill shape. So if I go like this, as you can see, that's what it's going to look like. Well, thicker, but shorter. So there you go. That's how you can kind of customize that particular heavy end tick mark. And of course, if you don't like this tick, you can always go down to arrowheads and then just, let's adjust that. Do something like 6. Okay. There we go. Looks a little bit cleaner. And there we go. That's how you can customize these arrowheads. As I said, there are limitations, which is annoying. But the cool part is the fact that we can still customize it a little bit. And that's what you've seen in this video. Now, if you want to get this actual project file, as I said, I have a whole course on my website, but also on my Patreon page, you can just get the project file without getting the course. And also you can get all of my Revit project files. I actually have like over 400 files. So if you're interested, please check it out. I'm going to link it in the description below this video and also up in the cards above. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.